Hi guys, I'm back. Today I'm going to Ezekiel 14 to 18, Psalm 36, and Proverbs 6. Let's get started. Some of the elders of Israel came to see me. They sat down with me. Then a message from the Lord came to me. The Lord said, "Son of man, these men have thought about nothing but other gods. They have fallen into the evil trap of worshiping me. Should I let these men ask me for any advice? Speak to me. Tell me. The Lord of Israel says, suppose any of the Israelites think about gods, and they fall into the evil trap of worshiping me. Then they go to a prophet to answer the question. If they do, I myself will tell the prophet to answer them in keeping with their worship of the God. I win back the hearts of the people of Israel. All of them have deserted me for the other gods. I speak to the people of Israel. Tell them, the Lord and King says, turn away from your sins. Listen, turn away from your gods. Give up the evil ones you've done. I hate them. Suppose any of the Israelites or any outsiders see that the Israelites separate themselves from me. And they think about other gods. They fall into the evil trap of worshiping. Then they go to a prophet to ask me for advice. If they do, I myself will ask the prophet to answer them. I will turn against them. I will make an example of Israel. People will talk about the bad thing that happened to you. I will remove them from me. Then you'll know that I am the Lord. Suppose that prophet is stirred up to give a prophecy. Then I am the one who has stirred him up, and I will reach out my powerful hand against him. And I will destroy him from amongst my people Israel. The prophet will be as much to blame as the Lord. And he asks him for advice. Both of them will be guilty. Then the people of Israel will no longer wander away from me. They will no longer make themselves unclean with their many sins. They will be my people, and I will be their God, and I serve the Lord and King. A message from the Lord came to me. The Lord said, "Son of man, suppose the people in a certain country sin against me, and they are not faithful to me. So I reach out my powerful hand against them. I cut off their food supply. I make them very hungry. I kill them and their animals. And suppose Noah, Daniel, and Job were in that country. Then these three men can save only themselves by doing what is right and assisting God and King. Well, suppose I send wild animals through that country and they kill all its children. It becomes a dry and empty desert. No one can pass through it because of the animals. And suppose these three men were in that country, then they could not save their own sons or daughters. They alone would be safe, but the land would become a dry and empty desert. And that is just as sure as I am alive, and as is the Lord King. And suppose I send swords to kill the people in that country, and I say, let swords sweep all through the land, and I kill its people and their animals. And suppose these three men were in that country, then they could not save their own sons or daughters. They alone would be safe. And that is just as sure as I am alive, and as is the Lord and King. Well, suppose I send a plague into that land, and I pour out my great anger on it by spilling blood. I kill its people and their animals. And suppose Noah, Daniel, and Job were in that land, then they could not save their own sons or daughters. They could save only themselves by doing what is right. And that is just as sure as I am alive, and this is the Lord and King. The Lord and King says, it will get much worse. I'll punish Jerusalem in all horrible ways. There will be war, hunger, wild animals, and plague. They will destroy the people and their animals, but some people will be left alive. Some children will be brought out of the city. They will come to you. You will see how they act and the way they live. Then you'll be comforted in spite of all the trouble I brought on Jerusalem. You'll be comforted when you see how they act and the way they live. Then you'll know that I did not do anything there without a reason, and I just Lord and King. A message from the Lord came to me. Here's what the Lord said. Son of man, how is the wood of a vine different from the wood of any tree in the forest? Can its wood ever be made into anything useful? Can wood ever be made into him? Can pegs be made from the tangism? Suppose it is thrown in the fire to be burnt, and the fire burns both ends and blackens the mill. Then is the wood useful for anything? It was not useful when it was hot, so how can it be made into something useful now? The fire has burned it and blackened it. Here's what the Lord and King says. Instead of the wood of any tree in the forest, I give them the vine to burn in the fire. We'll treat the people of Israel in the same way. I'll turn against them. They might have come out of the fire, but the fire will destroy them anyway. I'll turn against them. Then you'll know that I am the Lord. I'll make the land a dry and empty desert. My people have not been faithful to me, and as is the Lord and King. The message from the Lord came to me. The Lord said, Son of man, tell the people of Jerusalem the evil things they've done. I hate those things. Tell them. The Lord and King speaks to Jerusalem. He says, Your history in the land of Canaan goes back a long way. Your father was an Amorite. Your mother was a Hittite. On the day you were born, your cord was not cut. You were not washed with water to clean you up. You were not rubbed with salt, and you were not wrapped in large strips of cloth. No one took pity on you. No one was concerned enough to do anything, any of these things for you. Instead, you were thrown out into an open field. You were hated on the day you were born. As I was passing by, I saw you kicking around in your blood. I didn't want that. I said to you, live. I made you grow like a plant in the field. Soon you were grown up. You became a young adult. Your breasts had formed. Your hair was hot, but you were completely naked. Later, I was passing by again. I looked at you. I saw that you were old enough for love. So I married you and took good care of you. I covered your naked body. I made a firm promise to you. I entered into a covenant with you. And you became mine, and answered the Lord again. I bathed you with water. I washed the blood off you. And I put lotions on you. I put a beautiful dress on you. I gave you sandals made out of fine leather. I dressed you in fine linen. I covered you with expensive clothes. I decorated you with jewelry. I put bracelets on your arms. I gave you a necklace for your neck. I put rings on your nose and ears. I gave you a beautiful crown for your head. So you were decorated with gold and silver. Your clothes were made out of expensive and beautiful. Your food was made out of honey, olive, and the finest flour. You became very beautiful. You became a queen. You were so beautiful that your fame spread among the nations. The glory I gave you made your beauty perfect in my system. But you trusted in your beauty. You used your fame to become a prostitute. You offered your body freely to anyone who passed by. In fact, you gave yourself to anyone who wanted. You used some of your clothes to make hearts less colorful. This where people worshipped other gods. You were a prostitute man. You went to your lover and he took your beauty. I'd given you fine jewelry. It was made out of gold and silver. You used it to make for yourself statues of male gods. You worshipped those gods. You were not faithful to me. You put your beautiful clothes on. You offered my wine and incense to them. You also offered them food. It was made out of olive oil, honey, and the finest flour. I had given it to you to eat. You offered it a sweet smelling incense too. That is what you did, and this is the Lord King. Then you took your sons and daughters who belonged to you, and you sacrificed them as food to other gods. Was it enough for you to be a prostitute? You killed my children. You sacrificed them to other gods. You did not remember the days when you were young. At that time, you were completely wrong. You were cooking the land in your blood, but now you have done evil things. I hate them. You have worshipped other gods. You have not been faithful to me. How terrible it will be for you, now says the Lord and King. How terrible for you. You continue to sin against me. You people build up mounds for themselves in every market. They put little places of worship on Jews. They set them up at every street corner. Jews, you misuse your beauty. You offered your body to anyone who passed by. You did it again and again. You committed shameful acts with the people of Egypt. They were your neighbors who were ready to have sex with you. You offered yourself to them again and again. That made me very angry. So I reached out my powerful hand against you. I made you turn to a small. I handed you over to your Philistine. And the people in their towns were shocked by your impure conduct. You also committed shameful acts with the people of Syria. Nothing ever seemed to satisfy you. You could never get enough. Then you offered yourself to the people of Ben, but that didn't satisfy you either. There are many traitors in the land of Israel. I am filled with great anger against Nazareth's people and king. Just look at all the things you are doing. You are acting like a prostitute who has no shame at all. Your people build up mountains at every sheep. You put your places of worship on them in every month. Well, you did not really act like a prostitute. That's because you refuse to let your lovers pay you anything. Your unfaithful wife, you would rather be with strangers than with your own husband. Every prostitute receives gifts. Instead, you give gifts to all your lovers. You offer them money and to come to you from everywhere. You want them to sleep with you. You are exactly the opposite. You pay them. They do not pay you. You prostitute. Listen to the Lord's message. The Lord and King says, you brought out your design on your lovers. You took off your clothing and slept with them. You did it again and again. You worshipped other gods. I hate them. You even sacrificed your children to them. So I am going to gather together all the lovers you found pleasure with. They include those you love and those you hate. I will gather them against you from everywhere. I will take your clothes and come off right in front of you. Then they will see you completely naked. I will hand down my sentence against you. You will be punished like women who commit adultery and sacrifice their children to other gods. I am so angry with you, so I will sentence you to death for everything you have done. Then I will hand you over to your lovers. They will tear down the mounds you have built. They will destroy the little places of worship you put on them. They will take your clothes off. They will remove your fine jewelry, and they will leave you completely naked. They will bring a crowd against you. A crowd will put you to death by throwing stone dead. And they will chop you to pieces with their swords. They will burn down your houses and punish you. Many women will see you. They will not let you be a prostitute anymore. You will no longer pay your lovers. Then my great anger against you will die down. My jealous anger will turn away from you. I will not be angry anymore. You do not remember the days when you were young. The things you did made me very angry. So anything that happens to you will be your own fault. And that says the Lord again. You added impure conduct to all the other evil things you did. I hate all those things. All those who use Proverbs will use this one about you. They say, like mother, like daughter. You are a true daughter of your mother. She hated her husband and children. And you are a true sister of your sisters. They hated their husbands and children. Your mother was a Hittite. Your father was an Amorite. Your older sister was Samaria. She lived north of you with her daughters. Your younger sister was Sodom. She lived south of you with her daughters. You lived exactly the way they did. You copied their evil practices. I hate those practices. Everything you did was so simple that you soon became even worse than they were. Your sister Sodom and her daughters never did what you and your daughters have done. And that is just as sure as I am alive, and as is the Lord and King. Here's the sin your sister Sodom committed. She and her daughters were proud. They ate too much. They were not concerned about others. They did not help those who were poor and in need. They were very proud. They did many things that were evil in my eyes. I hated those things. So I got rid of Sodom and her daughters, just as you have seen. Samaria did not commit half the sins you did. He sinned even more than they did. I hate those sins. Compared to what you did, you made your sisters seem godly. so you'll be dishonored. You have given your sisters an excuse for what they did. Your sins were far worse than this. In fact, your sisters appear to be more godly than you. So then, be ashamed. You'll be destroyed. You'll have made them appear to be godly. I will not only give you back what you had before, I will also do the same thing for Sodom and her daughters. And I will do the same for Samaria and her daughters. That will make you feel dishonored. You will be ashamed of everything you've done. You have made them feel better because you sinned. Because you sinned more and were punished more than they were. Your sisters, Sodom and Samaria, and their daughters will return to what they were before. And you and your daughters will return to what you were before. In the past, you would not even mention your sister Sodom. You were proud at that time. That was before your sin was uncovered. Now the daughters of Adam make fun of you. So do all her neighbors and the daughters of all the Philistines. Everyone who lives around you hates you. You will be punished for your impure conduct. I will also punish you for the other evil things you have done. I hate all those things and answers them. The Lord King says, I will punish you in keeping with what you have done. I sealed with a promise the covenant I made with you. You hated that promise, and you broke my covenant. But I will remember my covenant with you. I made it with you when you were young. Now I will make a new covenant with you. It will last forever. Then you will remember how you have lived. You will be ashamed when I give you Samaria and Sodom. Samaria is your older sister. Sodom is your younger one. I will give them and their daughters to you as daughters. That can't happen based on my old covenant with you. So I will make my new covenant with you. Then you will know that I am the Lord. I will pay for all the sins you have committed. Then you will remember what you have done. You will be ashamed of it. Because of your shame, you will never speak against me again. And that is the Lord King. A message from the Lord came to me. The Lord said, Son of man, tell the people of Israel a story about their kings. Let them know what will happen to you. Tell them. The Lord and King says, a great evil came to the city of Levan. It had powerful wings and a lot of long feathers. The feathers were colorful and beautiful. It broke off the highest tree. The evil carried it away to the land of Balaam. There are many traders in that land. The evil planted the twig in the city of Balaam. Then it took from the seed that had just grown. It put it in rich soil that near plenty of water. It planted the seed like a willow tree. The seed grew into a low-spreading vine. Its branches turned toward the eagle, and its roots remained under the eagle. So the seed became a vine. It produced branches and put out leaves. But there was another great eagle. It also had powerful wings and a lot of feathers. That the vine now sent out its roots toward that eagle. It sent them out from the place where it was planted, and it reached out its branches to the eagle for water. The seed had been planted in good soil near plenty of water. Then it could produce branches and bear fruit. It could become a beautiful vine. Ezekiel, tell the Israelite. The Lord and King asks, will the vine grow? Won't it be pulled up by its roots? Won't all its fruit be stripped off? Won't it dry up? All its new growth will dry up. It will not take a strong arm or many people to pull it up. It is being planted. But will it grow? No. It will dry up completely when the east wind strikes it. It will dry up in the place where it grew. A message from the Lord came to me. The Lord said, these people will refuse to obey me. Ask them, don't you know what these things mean? Tell them, Nebuchadnezzar went to Jerusalem. He was the king of Babylon. He carried off King Jehoiachin and the nobles. He brought them back with him to the city of Babylon. Then Nebuchadnezzar made a peace treaty with Ezekiel. He was a member of Jerusalem's royal family. Nebuchadnezzar made him promise he would keep the treaty. He also took away the leading men of the land as prisoners. He did it to bring down their kingdom. It would not rise again. In fact, it would be able to last only by keeping his treaty. But Zedekiah turned against him. He sent messengers to Egypt. they went there to get horses and a large army. Will he succeed? Will he just things like that escape? Can he break the peace treaty and still escape? Ezekiel will die in pain, and that's his royal king. And that's just as sure as I'm alive. He'll die in the land of King Nebuchadnezzar. He put him on the throne. Ezekiel didn't keep his promise to Nebuchadnezzar and broke his treaty. So Nebuchadnezzar will build ramps against the walls of Jerusalem. He'll set up war machines to destroy many lives. Pharaoh will not be able to help Ezekiel during the war. The huge and mighty army of Egypt will not be of any help. Ezekiel didn't keep his promise to Nebuchadnezzar and broke his treaty. Ezekiel had made a firm promise to keep it, but he broke it anyway, so he will not escape. The Lord and King said, Ezekiel didn't keep the promise he made on my name. He broke the treaty, so I will pay him back, and that's just as sure as I am alive. I will spread out my net to catch him. He will be caught in my trap. I will bring him to Babel. I will judge him there because he was not faithful to me. All Zedekiah's best troops will be killed by swords. Those who are left alive will be scattered to the winds. Then you will know that I have spoken. I am the Lord. The Lord and King says, I myself will get a twig from the very top of the cedar tree and plant it. I will break off the highest twig. I will plant it on a very high mountain. I will plant it on the branches and bear fruit. It will become a beautiful cedar tree. All kinds of birds will make their nests in it. They will live in the shade of its branches. All the trees in the forest will know that I bring down tall trees. I will make short trees grow tall. I drive green trees, and I make dry trees green. I have spoken. I will do this. I am the Lord. A message from the Lord came to me. The Lord said, you people have a problem about the land of Israel. What do you mean by it? It says, the parents eat sour grapes, but the children have a bitter taste in their mouth. You'll not use that proverb in Israel anymore, announces the Lord and King. And there's just as sure as I am alive. Everyone belongs to me. Parents and children alike belong to me. A person will die because of their own sins. Suppose there's a godly man who does what is fair and right, and he does not eat at the mountain temples. He does not worship the statues of Israel's God. He does not sleep with another man's wife. He does not have sex with his own wife during a monthly period. He does not treat anyone badly. Instead, he always returns things he takes to make sure loans are paid back. He does not steal. Instead, he gives his food to hungry people. He provides clothes for those who are naked. He does not charge interest when he lends money to them. He does not make money from them. He keeps himself from doing what is wrong. He judges cases fairly. He obeys my rules. He is faithful in keeping my laws. He always does what is right. You can be sure he will live, and answers the Lord and King. But suppose he has a mean son who harms other people. The son commits murder, or he does some other things that are wrong. Suppose he does these things, even though his father never did. Suppose the son eats at the mountain temples, and he sleeps with another man's wife. He treats poor and needy people badly. He steals. He does not pay what he owes. He worships statues of gods. He does other things I hate. He charges interest when he lends money to poor people. He makes money from them. Will a man like that live? He will not. He will have to be put to death. And what happens to him will be his own fault. Well, he did many things I hate. But suppose this son has a son of his own, and the son sees all the sins his father commits. He sees them, but he does not do them. Suppose he does not eat at the mountain temples, and he does not worship the statues of Israel's gods. He does not sleep with another man's wife. He does not treat anyone badly. He does not make people give him something to prove they will pay back what they owe him. He does not steal. Instead, he gives his food to hungry people. He provides clothes for those who are naked. He keeps himself from committing sins. He does not charge interest when he lends money to poor people. He does not make money from them. He heeds my laws and obeys my rules. He will not die because of his father's sins. You can be sure he will live. But his father will die because of his own sin. He will grow up rich by cheating others. He will rob his relatives. He said to all among his people. But he still asks, is the son guilty along with his father? No, the son did what was fair and right. And he was careful to obey all my rules. So you can be sure he will live. A person will die because of their own sins. A child will not be guilty because of what their parent did. And a parent will not be guilty because of what their child did. The right things a godly person does will be added to their account. The wrong things a sinful person does will be charged against them. But suppose a sinful person turns away from all the sins they have committed, and they obey all my rules. They do what is fair and right, then you can be sure they will live. They will not die. None of the sins they have committed will be held against them. Because of the godly things they have done, he will live. When sinful people die, it does not give me any joy, and answers the Lord. But when they turn away from their sins and live, that makes me very happy. Suppose a godly person stops doing what is right, and they sin. They die the same evil things a sinful person does. They do things I hate. Then they will not live. I will not remember any of the right things they have done. They have not been faithful to me. They have also committed many other sins. So they are guilty. They will die. But you see, what the Lord does isn't fair. Listen to me, you Israelites. What I do is always fair. What you do is not. Suppose a godly person stops doing what is right, and they sin. Then they will die because of it. They will die because of the sin they have committed. But suppose a sinful person turns away from the evil things they have done, and they do what is fair and right, then they will save their life. They think about all the evil things they have done, and they turn away from them. So you can be sure they are there. They will not die. But the Israelites still say, what the Lord does is fair. People of Israel, what I do is always fair. What you do is not. So I will judge you, Israelites. I will judge each of you in keeping with what you have done, and answers the Lord. Okay. Turn away from Israel. Turn away from all the evil things you have done. Then sin will not bring you down. I have rid of all the evil things you have done. Let me give you a new heart and a new spirit. Then you will be faithful to me. Why should you die, people of Israel? When anyone dies, it does not give me any joy, and answers the Lord and King. So turn away from your sins, then you'll live. Proverbs 6. My son, don't promise to pay for what your neighbor owes. Don't agree to pay a stranger's bill. Don't be trapped by what you said. Don't be caught by the words of your mouth. Instead, my son, do something to free yourself. Don't fall into your neighbor's hands. Go until you can't get any more. Don't let your neighbor rest. Don't let your eyes go to sleep. Don't let your eyelids close. As a deer frees itself from a hunter, free yourself. As a bird frees itself from a trapper, free yourself. If you really don't want to work, think about the end. Consider its ways and be wise. It is no commander. It is no leader, but it stores up its food in summer. It gathers its food at harvest time. You lazy people, how long will you lie there? When will you get up from your sleep? You might sleep a little or take a little nap. You might even fold your hands and rest. Then you would be poor, as if someone had robbed you. You would have little, as if someone had stolen from you. An evil troublemaker goes around saying twisted things with his mouth. He winks with his eyes. He makes signals with his feet. His motions are evil. His fingers. His plans are evil. And he has lies in his heart. He is always stirring up fights. Trouble catch up with him in an instant. He will suddenly be destroyed, and nothing can save him. There are 6 things the Lord hates. In fact, he hates 7 things. The Lord hates proud eyes, a lying tongue, and hands that kill those who are guilty. He also hates hearts that make evil plans, and feet that are quick to do evil. He hates any witness who pulls out lies, and anyone who stirs a conflict in the community. My son, keep your father's command. Don't turn away from your mother's teaching. Always tie them on your heart. Put them around your neck. When you walk, they will guide you. When you sleep, they will watch over you. When you wake up, they will speak to you. Your father's command is like a lamp. Your mother's teaching is like a light. And whatever instructs and corrects you leads to life. It keeps you from your neighbor's wife. It keeps you from the smooth talk of a woman who commits adultery. Don't hang in your heart after a beauty. Don't let our eyes capture you. A prostitute can be bought for only a loaf of bread. But another man's wife hunts your very life. You can't shovel fire into your lap without burning your flesh. You can't walk on hot coals without burning your feet. It's the same for anyone who has sex with another man's wife. Anyone who touches her will be punished. People don't hate a thief who steals to fill his stomach, empty stomach. But when he is caught, he must pay 7 times as much as he stole. It may even cost him everything he has. The man who commits adultery has no sense. Anyone who does it destroys himself. Will be beaten up and dismayed. His shame will never be wiped away. Jealousy stirs up a person's anger. He will show no mercy when he gets eaten. He won't show any pain. He won't take any money, no matter how much he is offered. Psalm 36. I have a message from God in my heart. It is about the evil ways of anyone who sins. They don't have any respect for God. They praise themselves so much that they can't see their sin or hate it. Their mouths speak words that are evil and false. They do not act wisely or do what is good. Even as they lie in bed, they make evil plans. They commit themselves to a sinful way of life. They never say no to what's wrong. Lord, your love is as high as the heavens. Your faithful love reaches up to the sky. Your holiness is as great as the height of the highest mountains. You are as honest as the oceans are deep. Lord, you keep people and animals safe. How priceless your faithful love is. People find safety in the shadow of your wings. They eat well because there is more than enough in your house. You let them drink from your river that flows with good things. You have the fountain of life. We are filled with light because you give us light. Keep on loving those who love you. Keep on doing right to those whose hearts are honest. Don't let the fear of those who are proud step on me. Don't let the hands of those who are evil drive me away. See how those who do evil are formed. They are thrown down and can't get up. Now that's done, I shall now do the Lord's prayer. Please bow your heads. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our debts as you have also forgiven our debtors. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from the evil one. For yours is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen. See you tomorrow. Bye.